good questions before us today, I go to the Bible to find answers. Question number one for today. Please explain Revelation 22, verse 2. Why is healing needed in a land where there is no pain or death? Dear friend, you are absolutely correct. In heaven, there's no sin, no sorrow, no pain, no death. And yet here in Revelation 22, verse 2, it talks about the leaves of the tree for the healing of the nations. There'll be no sickness there. There'll be no sorrow there. I take this simply to be a poetic way of describing a place of perfection where sickness and sorrow will never be a part of the landscape. The leaves of the tree, healing of the nations, perfect peace in that realm to which we go. And now question number two. Can one be filled with the Spirit yet not speak in tongues? Well, in the Bible, tongues are said to be a gift of God. 1 Corinthians chapter 12, we are told that they are for self-edification, and when you speak in tongues, you speak not unto men, but unto God, who hears you in secret. Speaking in tongues, as well as a flame of fire on each head, was a sign of the outpouring of the Holy Spirit in Acts chapter 2. The question, however, is this: can one be filled with the Holy Spirit without the manifestation of speaking in tongues? The Bible answer is that speaking in tongues, although useful, is not necessarily a sign of deep spirituality. It may come as a surprise to some to know that the Apostle Paul, when talking to the people in Corinth, said, "You are carnal, you aren't spiritual, you are babes in Christ." And yet he said that that church came behind in no gift, so they spoke in tongues a great deal at Corinth. Speaking in tongues is a manifestation of the Holy Spirit, but the real sign of being filled with the Spirit is that you demonstrate the fruit of the Spirit: love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law. And now question number three. Does Mary have special status in heaven? Will angels be needed in eternity? Well, this is a double question. Angels who are now servants of the heirs of salvation, according to Hebrews 1:14, will join the choirs of heaven forever to praise God and His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. And so, of course, angels will have their part to play. What about Mary? She will not lose her reward. 1 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 8, tells us that everyone will receive his own reward. So you don't have to worry about Mary. She will receive her reward in eternity, as you and I will receive our reward if we trust in God and follow Him fully. Thank you so much for these good questions. I trust the answers have been a blessing. If you have a question you'd like me to use on The Bible Has the Answer, please write it out, send it to me. I'll be pleased to hear from you, and I'll get to your question on the air just as quickly as I can. When you write, all the address you need is simply Faith to Live By, Box 426, Winnipeg, Manitoba, and the code is R3C2H6. Jim and Rick now, O Little Town of Bethlehem.